Hello everybody, I am Mika Vasiani. Welcome you all to Learn English with Saraswati Group of Education. Today, we are going to learn a grammar point which is connected with the chapter The Fifth Golden Ticket. The name of the grammar is Transitive and Intransitive Verbs. Now you will think we have already learned verbs, right? Verbs means doing words, action words. But what do you mean by different types of verbs? That is transitive and intransitive verbs. Let me explain you in detail. Okay? There are two types of verbs. They are known as transitive verb and intransitive. Now, what is the difference between transitive verb and intransitive verb? Okay, the difference is transitive verbs needs an object to convey the meaning. To convey the meaning of what? The meaning of sentence. Okay, to complete the meaning of sentence, transitive verbs need object. Okay, you might be a little bit confused. Let us understand with example. Okay, suppose if I am writing here father aloud, okay, only two words, father aloud, and then the sentence is over, but there is no meaning conveyed. You will not be able to understand what did father allow. Father aloud, over, then you will be confused. There is no complete meaning made by the sentence. Okay, for that you will keep on thinking, what did father allow? So, the verbs which need an object to complete its meaning, those type of verbs are known as transitive verbs. Okay? If we ask the sentence, what? Is there any word to answer from the sentence? Father allowed. What? There is no word left here to convey the complete meaning of the sentence. So those verbs which need object, here there is no object mentioned over here. Father allowed, simple. This is subject, this is predicate. No object in the sentence, right? So that type of sentence or that type of verbs which are expressed in the sentence but not with a complete meaning, without an object. That verb needs an object to complete its meaning. Now suppose if I say, father allowed Rina to go to swimming pool. Then, that is the object part, that is the complete part. But, father allowed to go to swimming pool, to go to swimming pool, that is object. Without that, father allowed, that does not make any sense. Right? So those type of verbs are known as transitive verbs, the verbs which need an object to convey the complete meaning are known as transitive verbs. Okay? And the other type of verbs, those are intransitive verbs. Now, what are intransitive verbs? Intransitive verbs are the verbs which do not require an object to convey the complete meaning. Okay, in them it already contains the meaning, so that will not require any object in the sentence to convey the complete meaning, to make the opposite person understand. Okay, for example, Charlie talked for hours. Charlie talked for hours. For here, Charlie, if we just consider Charlie talked. Okay, if we consider subject and predicate only, Charlie talked, then also we can understand that yes, there is some action done by Charlie, that is Charlie talked. Over, the meaning is conveyed. Now here, this does not require Charlie talked for hours. Okay, if we ask the sentence, Charlie talked what? Then also, this makes some sense. Charlie talked. Yes, Charlie did that activity. Charlie talked. Charlie talked for hours. So this is object. But this object is not necessarily required in the sentence to complete its meaning. Right? To convey its full meaning. So these type of verbs which does not require to convey the complete meaning of the sentence, that type of verbs are known as intransitive verbs. Okay? Intransitive verbs. Once again, the verbs which require an object to convey the complete meaning of the sentence, those type of verbs are known as transitive verbs. Okay? And the verbs which do not require any object to convey the complete meaning of the sentence, those type of verbs are known as intransitive verbs. Now you will say, madam, this is so confusing. Okay? We don't remember all these transitive, intransitive, object, no object. We don't remember all these things. But there is a simple rule. Okay? A simple rule where we can identify transitive verbs and intransitive verbs easily. What is that rule? Here it is. Please read with me. Simple rule, okay? Simple rule to identify whether a verb is transitive or intransitive. That is to ask what or whom question to the sentence. We can ask to the sentence. Either we can ask what or we can ask whom to the sentence to find out whether the verb is transitive or intransitive. If we require the answer, if we get the answer by asking the question what or whom, okay, and the answer is necessary to complete the meaning, then it is a transitive verb because it requires an object. But if we ask to the sentence what or whom and the answer is not required, okay, without the answer also if we can identify the meaning of the sentence, then that is intransitive verb. Got it? Yes, I know. Still it will be clear with more examples. So let us do that. Let us make it more clear with examples. Okay? Transitive verbs, as I say, the verbs which require an object to convey the complete meaning of the sentence, those verbs are known as transitive verbs. And the verbs which do not require any object to complete the meaning, to convey the meaning of the sentence, those type of nouns or verbs are known as intransitive verbs. Got it? Okay, let us go through example first. Okay, that is Madhu likes dancing. Now, as you know that a simple rule is taught to you that how to identify a transitive or intransitive verb, that is to ask the sentence what or whom. Now if you ask the sentence Madhu likes dancing, if you ask the sentence Madhu likes what, so Madhu likes only does not make any meaning. It requires an object, that is dancing, that is necessary to convey the complete meaning. Okay, Madhu likes dancing. So dancing is required for the sentence to convey the complete meaning. Right? So here likes is transitive verb. Okay? Then if we see my mom wrote a letter. Now in that sentence, if I ask the sentence my mom wrote what? Okay? My mom wrote what? So only the part of the sentence my mom wrote does not make any meaning, does not convey the complete meaning of the sentence, does not make any sense. My mom wrote, but what? Okay, so there object is needed to complete the sense of the sentence, to convey the complete meaning of the sentence. That is, my mom wrote a letter. Then only we understand what did mother write. My mom wrote. We will not understand anything by only these words. A letter is needed. Okay? My mom wrote a letter. Got it? So, wrote is transitive verb. Okay? Meeta bought a bunch of flowers. Meeta bought what? Now, there we do not understand the complete meaning of the sentence. Meeta bought, but what? Meeta bought a bunch of flowers. That is needed to convey the complete meaning of the sentence. So, bought is transitive verb. Okay? Again, I am repeating. The verbs which need object. These are object of the sentence, right? Object. To complete the meaning. Okay? To convey the complete meaning of the sentence, those type of verbs are known as transitive verbs. Okay? Let us look at the other example. She left the cafe. Now, if we ask the sentence, she left what? We cannot complete the meaning, right, without the words the cafe. We cannot understand the complete sense of the sentence. She left, but what? So we don't understand. If there are no words, if I hide these words, she left, then what will you understand? Nothing, right? So to complete the sense of the sentence, we need these words. She left the cafe. Understood? So left is transitive verb because it needs the object to complete its meaning. Please buy two pens. Now if I hide this object, please buy. What will you understand from these two words? Nothing. I am just telling please buy. But what? That is not told. But if I say, please buy two pens, then only you will understand. So, two pens is object that is needed here to complete the meaning of the sentence. Okay? So, buy is transitive verb here in the sentence. Okay? If I say, mother was serving evening soup. Now, if I hide them, mother was serving. Mother was serving, but what? So that we do not understand, right? Mother was serving evening soup. Okay? Mother was serving evening soup. So then only we can come to know about the complete sense of the sentence. Okay? Let us have a look at the intransitive verbs example. Okay? The first example is Grandpa Joe jumped with joy. Now, as I have explained, in intransitive verb, we do not need object to complete the meaning of the sentence. Let us see it here. Grandpa Joe jumped. Now, if I hide the object, Grandpa Joe jumped, then also it makes sense without the words with joy. Grandpa Joe jumped with joy. So if I do not add the words with joy, then also it makes sense. Grandpa Joe jumped. Okay, it is conveying that Grandpa Joe did some activity of jumping. Grandpa Joe jumped. Complete. With joy is not needed. So those type of verbs which do not need an object to complete the meaning of the sentence, those type of verbs are known as intransitive verbs. Okay? She moved a sign. Now, if I hide the object, okay? She moved. Yes, she moved. A sign is not needed to complete the meaning of the sentence. Got it? Let us see the next one. The baby cried loudly. Now, if I hide the word loudly, that is object, will you be able to make out the meaning? The baby cried. Of course, yes. That is a complete meaning which is conveyed. The baby cried. So, we come to know, yes, the baby is crying. The baby cried. Okay? That does not require the word loudly complete meaning. Okay? Let us see the next one. A flock of birds is flying over our head. Okay? Now, a flock of birds is flying. Okay? If I hide the object. Okay? If I hide the object. A flock of birds is flying. Does that convey a complete meaning? Does that make a complete sense? Yes, we understand, right? The one who is listening to the sentence understands that yes, the birds are flying, simple. But this is the object which is added. A flock of birds is flying over our head. Okay, so that is told here. That is conveyed. The meaning is conveyed completely. Got it? So that is flying is intransitive verb. Let us go through the next example now. The next example is, it is raining heavily. It is raining heavily. Now here if I hide the word heavily. Okay? If I hide the word heavily. And the sentence is, it is raining. So, do you need that word heavily to express the meaning? No. The word heavily is not at all needed to express the complete meaning. Right? We can make out the meaning from the sentence, it is raining. It is raining. We can come to know about the meaning of the sentence. Yes, it is raining. Okay? She danced beautifully. Now, if I hide the word beautifully, if I hide the object beautifully, then can you make out she danced from these two words? Can you make out the meaning she danced? Yes, we can come to know about the meaning. She danced. Right? For that, we do not need the object that is beautifully. We come to know about the complete sense that she danced. Right? So, the verbs which require some object to complete its meaning, to convey the complete meaning of the sentence, that verb is known as transitive verb. Okay? And if the verb does not require an object to convey the complete meaning of the sentence, then that verb is known as intransitive verb. Okay? Intransitive verb does not require any object to convey the complete meaning of the sentence. Got it? Now with these examples, I am sure it will be clear in your mind. But if something is still there in your mind which is confusing you, then you may note it down and you can ask me that question during the live lecture. I can sort out your doubt at that time. Right? If you feel that you can forget, please note it down and keep that note with you during the live lecture. We will be able to solve that doubt there. Okay? Along with this video lecture, you are going to get a worksheet. In the worksheet, you will find one question. That some sentences will be written there and the question is, you have to identify that whether that particular verb which is given in the sentence is transitive or intransitive. So underline the verb and identify its type, whether it is transitive or whether it is intransitive. Okay, now there are two options of doing the worksheet. You can take the printout of the worksheet and write the answers in the worksheet itself, or you can copy the worksheet in your rough book. Okay, mind well, rough book. Understood? Yes. Now, if you are copying the worksheet in your rough book, please copy direct answers. Okay, write direct answers in your rough book. There is no need to copy the whole sentence and then underline and then write its type. No. If you are writing in the rough book, then you can directly find out the verb and write there and do a dash and and write the type of its work. Okay. But if you are taking the printout, then simply you can write it in the space given over there. No issues with that. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can ask me during the live lecture. Bye bye.